Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on NPV versus IRR. So, everyone or the investor who is trying to invest his money, or let's say who is planning to make investment decision, is always confused how to know its profitability. So, well, there are two most important approaches which are used, and they are NPV and IRR. So, let's assume that your organization has asked you to do some analysis whether the new project will be beneficial or not. So in this scenario, you would first analyze the project cost. You'll first analyze what? The first is the case of the project cost, and then try to evaluate its cash inflows and outflows, which is known as cash outflow. PV, it's called as present value of the cash inflow, and cash outflow, that is called as free cash flows. Next, you will check in how many years the cost of the project would be recovered and by what period of the time that project will start providing benefits. So in order to measure a lucrativeness of the project or long-term investment plans, there are some capital budgeting tools used by many organizations and individuals to find out the profitability of the project. And the most common tool which is used is NPV and IRR. And IRR. Okay. Both of these tools are majorly used to evaluate the profits from the investments, and they both have their own pros and cons. See, but the primary question is that which tool is beneficial? Is it NPV that is beneficial? Is it NPV that is beneficial, or is it IRR? So there are a lot of debate, and you must read which states NPV is better and measurable tool, well, other states that IRR. So in this tutorial, I'll be guiding you through the differences between the two and also which tool has more relevance. Now, let's go through some of the differences of NPV versus IRR. Let's see. So this guy is in question that what should be used for bank, for evaluating assets, for many other reasons. So let's start evaluating. First is the meaning. So NPV is the acronym, that is a synonym for the net present value, acronym for the net present value. Net present value is the amount of present value of the cash outflow and cash inflow. It's like the present value of the cash outflow less the present value of the cash inflow. So it's like PVCI, present value of the cash inflow less the present value of the cash outflow, PVCO. If this is positive, then you get NPV. Now, IRR. IRR means is the acronym for internal rate of return. It is known as the discount rate that makes NPV of all cash outflow and projected cash inflow equal. So it's like it's PVCO, that is present value of the cash outflow and present value of the cash inflow, are equal in case of IRR. So second, the explanation part. NPV. See, it is the expression in the form of the currency return. Okay, it is a form of in the form of the currency return which a company expects from a project. So over here, the portion is involved in terms of numerical value. So even if you will receive the NPV will be in terms of like $10,000 or $12,000 or $1 million and so on and so forth. Over here, IRR is expressed in terms of percentage of return a firm expects from the project. So basically, IRR is like, you know, they will tell you that, you know, at 10% interest rate, your present value of the cash outflow and present value of the cash inflow is equal. Now the measure. NPV is the absolute measure. Okay, it represents the value of the currency that is either added or lost by undertaking the project. So present value of the cash inflow, let's say if this is 10,000, then present value of the cash outflow is, let's say, 5,000. Then in this scenario, what is the difference? 5,000. 5,000 is your profit. And if not, if it is vice versa, then it will be loss. So it gives an absolute measure. IRR is basically a relative measure. It's you can relate that. It is a rate of return a project offers over its lifespan. Cash flow changes. NPV method can be used to evaluate the project or investments where there are changes in the cash flows. Okay. So if there are changes, like, you know, in year one, you have different cash flow, like in year one, there is 100 million. In year two, you have 200 million. In year three, there is 300 million and so on and so forth. So it can be used to evaluate projects or investment where there are changes in the cash flow. But IRR method cannot be used to evaluate projects where there is changing in the cash flow. It should be constant. The additional wealth. So NPV takes into account the additional shareholder's wealth for calculating the profitability of the project. So the additional wealth that has been created. IRR does not take into account the additional shareholders' wealth for calculating the profitability of the project, because over there the only analysis which is done is whether the at what rate the PVCO is equal to the PVCI. Acceptability NPV method is better understandable by general public, as it is easy to grasp. Yes, absolutely, because it's like the outflow less the inflow, or you can say whatever is coming in your pocket and whatever is going out of the pocket, the balance is your profit or loss. The IRR method is more used by the business managers, and it is better to understand the concept of the return stated in the percentages. So over here, in case of NPV, people understand this whole thing in terms of numbers. Over here, they understand in terms of percentage, and it is more used by the business managers. Over here, it is used for general public or as for a layman. The discount rates. If discount rates changes, NPV produces different results for the same project. Absolutely. Like if there is 10% discount rate, the NPV will be different. At 11% discount rate, NPV will be different. It's like as the discount rate increases, your cash flow will decrease. So that is the case with NPV. IRR produces the same result even if the discount rate changes for the same project. So that is what the difference is for the discount rates. Now the pro tip. If you are planning to invest in the long-term projects or any other investments, like, you know, buying machineries or let's say for investment purpose, NPV is considered as a better measure to analyze the profitability of that investments rather than IRR. As NPV considers the different count rates for the same project and also takes into account the cost of capital, because at the end of the day, discount rate includes everything. The discount rate is basically your weighted average cost of capital. It includes your KE, cost of equity, cost of debt, cost of preference share, everything. It includes everything. So now let's get into the advantages and disadvantages of NPV. Let's quickly get into the area of advantages and disadvantages of NPV. See, net present value at the end of the day is calculation of the present value of the cash inflow, that is cash inflow less the cash outflow, cash inflow and the present value of the cash outflow, which we have just studied, PVCI less the PVCO. So that is your NPV. The difference is NPV. So if you are investing in certain investments or project, if it is positive, that means if your NPV, that is net present value, if that is positive, that is greater than zero, then you can accept that project, and this will show that the NPV value to your wealth. But in case if your NPV is less than zero, then in that scenario, you should not accept the project. So let's evaluate some of the advantage and disadvantage of NPV. See, in case of the advantage of NPV, the first and the foremost thing is the time value of money is given more importance. TVM, time value of money, is given more importance. That is, the value of money today is more than the value of money received a year after now. Second is that the project profitability and risk factors are given high priority. So profit and you can say the risk are taken more into consideration. It helps you to maximize your wealth, as it will show your returns greater than the cost of capital. So WACC over here, basically. Fourth, it takes into consideration both before and after cash flow over the lifespan of the project. So basically, the consideration is both the after and before the before and after the cash flow over the lifespan of the project. Now let's see some of the disadvantage. Now the disadvantage, the first one, let's discuss. See, it might not give you the accurate decision when the two or more projects are unequal life. So if there is unequal life, you won't be having an exact answer. So that is one disadvantage. It will not give you the clarity how long a project or investment will generate positive NPV due to simple calculation. Third, you can say that, you know, NPV method suggests to accept that investment plan which provides positive NPV, but it does not provide accurate answer at what period the time you will achieve the positive NPV. So the last one, fourth one, is like, you know, calculating appropriate discount rate is difficult. So you can see the WACC calculation, you can say, is difficult because at the end of the day, there is a lot of estimation process. So there are some of the disadvantage and advantage of IRR. Let's discuss that. In case of the IRR, The first one is that you can use this for, at the end of the day, first you can use this approach of IRR as an alternative method to NPV. This method entirely depends on estimated cash flow, as it is a discount rate which tries to make NPV of the cash flows of a project equal to zero. So if you are using this method to make decision between two projects, then accept the project if the IRR is greater than the required rate of return. So basically you can say when IRR is greater than the RE, you should accept the project. Now let's see some of the advantages. See, this approach is mostly used by the financial managers, as I told you, and as it is expressed in terms of percentage form, so it is very easy for them to compare the required cost of capital. It will provide you an excellent guidance on the project value and the risk. You can say the project value and the associated risk. So this is one more advantage. IRR method, third one, IRR method gives you the advantage of knowing actual return of the money which you have invested today. So actual return can be tracked very easily with the help of this particular driver. The disadvantage of the IRR is that, you know, IRR tells you to accept the project or investment plan where the IRR is greater than the weighted average cost of capital. But in case if the discount rate changes every year, then it is very difficult to make such comparison. And if there are two or more mutually exclusive projects, they are projects where acceptance of one project rejects the other one. And you can say in that case, the IRR is not very effective. Now let's see one example. Let's say over here, XYZ company is planning to invest in a plant. It generates the following cash flows from the above information. Calculate the NPV and IRR if the discounting rate is 10% over here, which is given. So, and suggest whether the XYZ Limited should invest in this plant or not. You can download this on the IRR calculation. So NPV is basically your cash inflow divided by 1 plus R raised to the N, that is T, less the cash outflow. So over here, we have a couple of things. Cash outflow is equal to the total project cost. The first step over here is the project the cash flows expected discount rate and apply the NPV formula in the Excel. So this is number of year over here. This is the cash outflow and this is the cash inflow. This is the discount rate where you have to use, and then after use the NPV formula, the rate value, the first value and the second value. So rate includes the discount rate. The value one includes the cash inflows. Okay. And value two includes the cash outflow. And when you apply this, you get your NPV. The next step is to add the cash outflow to the NPV formula. The step two is basically once you calculate the NPV, you just need to add the cash outflow. NPV step three, sum total to find the net present value. So this is how the NPV value has been found. The IRR formula is basically cash flow divided by 1 plus IRR rate raised to N is equal to cash outflow. So in this step, the IRR step one is first you have to list down all the details. The discount rate is 10%. You have the NPV. So IRR is equal to value and guess. So value will include all the cash flows of the projects. Okay. All the, it includes everything. That is cash outflow and inflow. So basically from the above calculation, you can see that the NPV generated by the plant is positive and IRR is close enough to, you can say 14%. IRR is close enough to, you can say C33 to C38. Once you do that, you see the IRR is close enough to 14%. So this implies that when discounting rate will be around 14%, the NPV will become zero. Hence, XYZ company can invest in this plant. So the final conclusion is that, as I can conclude that if you are evaluating two or more mutually exclusive projects, so better go for NPV method instead of IRR method, because it is safe to depend on NPV method for selecting the best investment plan due to its realistic assumption and better measure of profitability. So even you can make your use of IRR method, it is greater complement to NPV and will provide you an accurate analysis for investment decision. And also NPV finds its usage in discounting, that is discounted cash flow method, which is known DCF valuation, to find the present value of the cash flows to the firm. Thank you, everyone.